Champions of Anger, the Assemblers, Part 10. Mongina had healed from his Bialian sacrifice. He had concerns about some of the new galactic citizens, though, arriving on Angor in recent times, since the Red Militia had voted to bring it in. Many of these were invoking celestial powers for intervention in Angor, and the metaphysical world was in chaos. A particular group, the adherents of Kadra-Ra, the sun deity of the Kadralian Federation, were using power to bring endless sunny days to their liking. They had gone their old sacrifices as well, and were murdering citizens for their god, Kadra-Ra. Champions of Anger approached the cult headquarters, but they all feigned innocence. They set a cult compound. They raided the cult compound and freed some of the captives who were scheduled for sacrifice. The cult leader feels the champions are going to be a problem, though, and has the warrior of Kadra-Ra sent from the homeworld to fight the champions. The warrior confronts the champions in front of Angor City Parliament, and there is a battle. He wounds Mongina and declares to them the sovereignty of Kadra-Ra, the deity, before flying off. Mongina was taken to Angor City Hospice and given treatment. Champions then later travelled back to the cult headquarters, but the leader told them that the warrior had returned to the Federation. They returned to Angor City, but before they had left, Sacred Dove had put on a disguise to investigate the cult headquarters privately. She was caught, though, and taken to a private compound outside the city. Blue Jay assembled the Blue Squadron. I was concerned about the absence of Sacred Dove. Now, where has she gotten to? He commented. Warrior of Kadra-Ra returns soon enough, spotted in Jungda City. The champions travelled there to confront him. He was preaching at a crowd of people, and his followers were handing out pamphlets promoting their cult. Warrior apologized to the champions and said that they got off to a bad start. Kadra-Ra provides for all, he told them. They issued him a notification to register with an official visa, but apart from that, allowed him to carry on with his work. The policy won't change, said Red Jay. We welcome intergalactic visitors. Angor is a galactic civilization. And when these visitors sacrifice our citizens to the sun, do we welcome them then? Asked Blue Jay in reply. Don't be so dramatic, Blue Jay, said Red Jay. There are always teething problems with new arrivals. That's one word for it, replied Blue Jay. Blue Jay wandered off and mused himself. Now where is that Sacred